New question, member from Toronto Danforth.
Thank you, Speaker. Speaker, my question to the Premier. Last week, the CEO of the privatized Hydro One defended sharp rate increases he's seeking to benefit investors. He told the Empire Club that the rate increases were needed for capital investments to keep the system reliable. But the Ontario Energy Board didn't believe this. They told Hydro One to reduce its revenue demands. Hydro One has basically refused and came back with nearly the same demand. Let's be clear. Hydro One is not seeking this money to improve service. It wants this money so it can build an empire, including its ridiculous $6 billion purchase of Avista. Why is the Premier allowing Hydro One to expand its monopoly at ratepayers' expense?
Minister of Energy.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. When it comes to Hydro One's ask into the OEB, it is just that, Mr. Speaker. It's an ask, and the OEB will do its due diligence and again review this this application. But let's be clear, Mr. Speaker. The Fair Hydro Plan talks about the 25% reduction that we've brought forward for all families right across this province, all residences, Mr. Speaker, and then, of course, for 500,000 small businesses and farms. That 25% is taking effect. And then the cost, Mr. Speaker, will rise only by the cost of inflation for the next 4 years. So, Mr. Speaker, Hydro One is looking at what its needs are. It put forward its plan to actually continue to make our system reliable. We spent $70 billion making sure that we could rebuild this system, Mr. Speaker, and we need to continue to maintain it. That's what this ask is about. The OEB will review it, with always making sure that it keeps the best interests of customers in mind, Mr. Speaker.
Supplementary.
Thank you, Speaker. Again to the Premier. 2 years ago, the Premier promised that Hydro One would lower hydro rates excuse me, after it became a private corporation. But the privatized Hydro One refuses to lower rates even after the Premier gave it a $2.6 billion tax cut. In fact, Hydro One is taking the Ontario Energy Board to court so it can keep 100% of that tax break and leave nothing for ratepayers. It's refusing to be regulated by the OEB and is demanding sharp rate increases in order to expand its monopoly, while doing nothing to improve its performance for Ontario families and businesses. Will the Premier finally admit that her sell-off of Hydro One has been a complete failure?
Thank you. Minister.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And the ownership of Hydro One does not change how rates are reviewed by the OEB, Mr. Speaker. It also does not change the fact that rates will only go up by the rate of inflation, Mr. Speaker, not by the fear-mongering coming from the NDP. But let's look very clearly at what's happened with Hydro One rates, Mr. Speaker. Hydro One urban customers have seen a 25% reduction, Mr. Speaker, just like every other family right across the province. On top of that, Mr. Speaker, the rates for Hydro One R1 and R2 customers have dropped between 40 and 50%, Mr. Speaker. That is a huge reduction for those families. On top of that, Mr. Speaker, Hydro One has voluntarily stepped forward and cancelled the winter disconnections. They stepped forward and voluntarily ended the security deposits, Mr. Speaker. When it comes to seeing a company grow, they're actually growing and becoming more customer-focused and making sure the money that we got from the broadening of the ownership that we can use to build infrastructure right across the province.